In Genesis 1 verse 22, and God said, be fruitful, multiply. Be fruitful. Meaning, if God said, be fruitful, no man can utter it. No woman can utter it. Because God has spoken. Whose report will you believe? And God told you, be fruitful. They will believe in you. Exodus 1 verse 7. While we are standing, let's look at it. Can it come up to the screen? Exodus. Exodus speaks of movement. Somebody is about to receive speed to move this morning. In the name of Jesus, what was not working will begin to work. Are you shouting amen or you are shouting amen? The problem with many of us have as a believer, we want people to celebrate us. Don't wait for people to celebrate you. Celebrate yourself. Don't wait for anybody. Are we there? Okay, let's read it. Exodus 1 verse 7. And the children of Peter were fruitful. Is it like that in your scripture? And the children of Omega were what? Are you sure? You are not saying it like you mean it. There is something you need to see from this scripture. There is something you need to see from this scripture. There is something you need to see. And if you can get hold on that thing, it will change everything around for you. Let's look at the scripture. And the children of Omega were what? Are you afraid to say it? Are you sure? Were they beggar? Were they borrowers? Are you sure? Look at it very well now. He said Israel. It's not Israel. It's Omega. Is somebody with me? It's not Israel. You put your name there. We are what? Fruitful. And what? Increase. Small. Quarterly. Few. Abundantly. And what? They multiply. And was exceedingly mighty. And the land was what? Empty of them. Look at the scripture again. Because there is something you need to see. Until the light entered you, barrier cannot be broken. He said that the eyes of your understanding be enlightened. I came to speak to your spirit. That what was not working, is because of you. Because you have not seen what will make it work. Now that you have seen what will make it work, there is no reason for you not to be fruitful. No, there is no reason. If you are not fruitful, it's your curse. God's word cannot be broken. I told you I'm going to show you three. Let's read it one more time again. Then we go to another scripture. And the children of Omega were what? Fruitful. Meaning, well, to be fruitful means to produce. None shall be barren. Fruitful financially. Fruitful materially. Fruitful spiritually. Fruitful academically. Fruitful in all ramifications of life. And it didn't stop there. And he said it also increased from one level to another, from one place to another. It didn't stop. Increase, meaning, what is increase? Increase is a progressive measure. You have $1,000 today, next week you have $10,000. It's increase. Not you have 10,000, 3 weeks later you have 500. That's not increase. The increase is talking about, this is God's word to you. And they will increase abundantly and multiply. Meaning multiplication is of God. And was exceedingly mighty. He was not small. I speak over your life, you will not be small this season. Genesis 26, verse 22. Talking about fruitfulness. I came to speak to your soul. If you can see something this morning, rather this afternoon, something will happen. Something. Genesis 26. And he removed from them. And Genesis 26, 22. Okay. Let it come up. Let's go. Want to go? Which land? In the land of America, you shall be what? He removed. Listen, this was Isaac. They removed from him the first one. Whatever you went through last year is last year. Whatever you went through last month is last month. The real you is emerging in this land. They remove from him. And they dig another. He moved forward. He dig another. And when it finished, they said, this land is fruitful. When others are saying story, himself was giving glory. Amen. In the midst when people are complaining, because you know and you have understanding of scripture, God's word cannot be broken. Amen. You listen, you have no reason not to be fruitful in this land. Amen. God said, be fruitful, multiply. Be fruitful, multiply. This is God's word. Say to yourself, 1 minute, open your mouth, pray. I shall be fruitful. Say, turn it into prayer, 1 minute, quickly. I shall be fruitful in this land, in this land, in this land, in this land. My children, my husband, my household, we shall be fruitful in this land. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. We shall be fruitful in this land. We shall be fruitful in this land. Open your mouth. We shall be fruitful in this land. We shall be fruitful in this land. In the name of Jesus Christ. As you have prayed, so shall it be. You may be seated. In Genesis 1 verse 22, and God said, be fruitful. Multiply. Be fruitful. Meaning, if God said, be fruitful, no man can utter it. No woman can utter it. Because God has spoken. Whose report will you believe? And God told you, be fruitful. Then why believe in the report of man? Who has the final say? God. So why believe in man?
Genesis 1:22. He said, be fruitful. Be what? Fruitful. So you have no reason not to be fruitful in this land. Your business has no reason not to be fruitful. Everything you set your hand has no reason not to be fruitful. Because the DNA you carry is the DNA of fruitfulness. Amen. You have been wired to be fruitful. Amen. You have been electrified to be fruitful. Amen. Look at this whole place. You can decide to turn off the light. Does it mean there is no light here? Talk to me now. If you turn off this old light now, does it mean there is no light here? But there is light. But you just turn it off. But it doesn't stop the light. Then when you decide to turn it on, the light will come on. So in other words, you decided to say to yourself, you are not fruitful. It is not God's word. When God created you, wired you, he wired you to be fruitful. He created you to be fruitful. He never created a barren land. He never created you to be barren financially. He never created you to be barren spiritually. He created you to be what? Fruitful. Tell your neighbor, say, I'm fruitful. Tell your neighbor, say, I'm fruitful. Are you saying it like you mean it? Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, look at me very well. I am fruitful. My hand is fruitful. Everything that is connected to me is connected to fruitfulness. What is fruitfulness? What is fruitfulness? I wrote here. When Jesus looked at the tree that refused to bring fruit, and he looked at the tree, this tree is not from me. He decided to do what? To curse the tree. Because what I created is fruitful. I never created something that is not fruitful. So when God looks at you, you are not fruitful, you are not God. You should look for your father. If ye are God here on earth, so you have everything to be fruitful. Fruitfulness is to reproduce. To reproduce. To duplicate. To multiply. To increase what you are doing it to another dimension. This is the reason you were created. Why will he be angry and say, any tree that is not bringing fruit is not in me? Meaning God hates someone that is not fruitful. If he's angry with those that are not fruitful, now look at your life. Don't let God be angry with you. Put every machinery in place to be fruitful. To bring forth fruit. He said, no man will eat of you. Because this season you are supposed to bring fruit. You are not supposed to exist. And he cursed the tree. And the tree died. Why? Because it was not fruitful. I speak to your spirit. I speak to your life. I speak to your body. Everything that has to do with you shall be fruitful today. I say shall be fruitful today. Every organs in your body shall be fruitful. In the name of Jesus Christ, be fruitful. God expected every person to produce fruit as a child of God. God expects something from you. As a child of God, the first assignment God expects from you is to be fruitful. Is to duplicate. Is to reproduce. Your Christian race, your prayer life, everything needs to be fruitful about you. Everything about you needs to be fruitful. And where we read, he said, in Exodus chapter 1, verse 7, he said, and the children of Israel and the children of Omega was fruitful. And they increased. They were not small. They moved forward. Where they enter, they conquer. You should have the mindset. You should have a mindset. You should have a mindset. The mindset that God said, be fruitful. And if God said, be fruitful, man cannot stop the fruit. When God said, be fruitful, the devil cannot stop the fruit. When God said, be fruitful, your uncle cannot stop the fruit. They might delay. They might fight the fruit, but they can't stop it. They can't stop it. One of the things you must understand about you, you are unstoppable. I speak over your life. You are unstoppable. I say you are unstoppable. In the midst of affliction, you will also be fruitful. Genesis. Let's look at Genesis 41, verse 52. In the midst of trouble, evil trouble has no right to stop the fruitfulness in you. So nothing has the capacity to hold God's fruitfulness in your life. Nothing. Nothing. Your children, everything about you. Genesis 41, verse 52. Are we there? Genesis. Okay. And the name of what? The name of the second called is Ephraim. And God has caused me to be what? Fruitful in the land of my affliction. Even in the land of his affliction, in the midst of trouble, he was still fruitful. In the midst of pain, it was still fruitful. In the land of my affliction, but the Lord still blessed me. In the place of trouble, the Lord still increased me. In the midst of trouble, the Lord still settled me. When men say there is a casting down, I say there is what? A lifting up. What you see matters a lot. What do you see about yourself? Whose report? Solomon was the only person that never fought war, but he was surrounded with enemies. He never threw one sword one day, but yet he was surrounded with enemies. And his enemies were bringing offering for him. Check your Bible. His enemies were bringing offering for him, coming to seek cancer. It was the only one. His father fought war, and he came. I can't continue like this. What must I do? What you don't know is in your way. The first battle you must fight is the battle of your mind. That's why I said you must renew your mind. I came to speak to your spirit. I came to speak to something about you. As a man thinketh in his heart, when you think of war, you see war. What do you think? I am tired of this level and I create a war for myself. There is a new way. There is a new thing I created for myself. What have you created for yourself? What do you want to see? When I wake up in the morning from my bed, there are some scriptures I put around myself. When I woke up, I see first one. And when I read it and the thing entered my mind, I move with the day. What do you want to see? What have you guided yourself with? In the midst of trouble, this man was still fruitful. In the midst of pain, this man was still fruitful. Why? Was he the only man there? No. But something just made the difference. I came to speak to your life. You will make the difference in this land. If your amen is better than your neighbor, you are the person I prayed for.
In the place of trouble,
you shall be fruitful.
I asked them, I said, people are complaining in Nigeria and they are still building houses, they are buying cars. So how come? Is it not the same country? And they are doing things. What do you want to see?
The first thing you must do in life is to look for the scripture that tally with your destiny. And the scripture has the right, has the power to structure your life. If you can get the scripture, hold it, use it, and it begins to create everything around you.
A young man was a very faithful tither, and he got to his poultry one day, and he saw that his bird were sick. He came to church, went to where they kept his tithe card, carried his own tithe card from the place, went to soak it inside water, and said, God, this is faithfulness I have been. I have never defrauded you. Why would this bird die? And this is where I will make money. And he gave the water, after soaking the tithe card inside water, and he removed the water, he gave it to the birds to drink. And he left. Came back the next day, the old bird were all healed. Nobody told him to do it. If that tithe card is what I am using to pay tithe, and I have my record are straight, let me prove it in this business. Very many of us, at times we take things for granted. Life is spiritual, and you must take everything spiritual. It's not physical. He didn't go to look for drugs. It sucked the tithe card inside water. It was when he was giving the testimony. Who told you? The old beds were healed. No one died. God will not do a man's job. He wants you to move so that he can move with you. He will not move first. He wants you to move. He has said, be fruitful. Have you held that word back to him? That everything about me. Everything around my household. Everything around my business. They must respond to fruitfulness. None shall be barren. Told you the story of that woman that was always giving that bishop cow. The only child died. And he put it on a pickup to go and give the same archbishop. Archbishop said, no, I tell them to take. He said, no, this is a cow. It's very big. It's different from the one that, but there is no convention. He said, I decided to bring this one very early. He said, Baba, come and see it. And the man came down, saw a dead child. As he wanted to go back, he held him. He said, this is how your God will pay me. For my faithfulness to you. Is this how your God will pay me for my faithfulness to you, sir? The man prayed all the prayer and the man said it was better for 10,000 stingy people to die than a child of a giver. And the boy sneezed back to me.
myself, meaning if you are extinguishing people, you are supposed to die. Yeah, that was my God. There are some questions I just ask myself. Why will God answer that kind of prayer? It is better for 10,000 stinging people to die than a child of a giver. And the boy came back to life. And I started asking myself questions. Many 10,000 people will just die for the child of a giver. And the boy came. It is better for 10,000 stinging people to die than a child of a giver. And the boy sneezed back to life. And I asked myself a question. Which category are you? Hezekiah turned his face to the wall. He said, remember God. What will you say to God? What do you have? The last scripture. And I told you I will not waste your time today. Genesis 28 verse 3. Be fruitful. Hold this scripture. Genesis 28, verse 3. Genesis 17, verse 20. Which one are we? 28, 3. And God Almighty blessed them and make thee what? And make thee what? Talk to me now. And make thee what? And what? And thou shalt what? Be of what? Genesis 17, verse 20. When you are not bringing fruit, you are not of God. You need to bring fruit. Want to go? Can we read together? Let's read this one together, then we'll call it a day. Want to go? And I have heard. Are you sure it's in your Bible? Let's go again. Want to go? And as for what? And how many of you know Ishmael? No, how many of you know Ishmael? And you know Ishmael was not a covenant child. How many of you know the time Ishmael was to die, that the mother needed water? And he said, do you think the woman did not look around and there was no water at that time? How come water came? One of the things you must know, who you follow, followed him as Elijah followed Elijah. When you don't follow, the woman followed that man, knew some covenant right that man was doing. Abraham, her husband. And when he got to a point, he threw the child somewhere and he stood there. The God of my husband showed up. That was how he turned his water. The covenant principle work when you know how to apply it. It's not for believer alone, as for Ishmael. So if Ishmael could be fruitful, what about you? Who is not a covenant child? Then what about you that is a covenant child, a legitimate child?
there are principles you are not putting to work that makes you struggle. It's the same God everywhere. It's the same formula. Don't do what others do. Do something that will make you outstanding. Let's stand on our feet. I'll give you 2-3 prayer points, then drop the mic. Whatever has vowed that you will not be fruitful, whatever is fighting against your fruitfulness. As for Ishmael, he shall be fruitful. You all know Ishmael. Are we ready to pray? Amen. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, from today, you shall be fruitful. If the person is not saying it well to you, look for somebody that will tell you well. Yeah? Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, from today, I prophesy, you shall be fruitful. In case the person never told you well, look for somebody that will tell you well. At the person again, say, I speak to your spirit. I speak to everything about you. You shall be fruitful. Are you ready? Let's do 2-3 prayer points, then we call it a day. Fruitfulness is your covenant right. God's word cannot be broken. Married many years ago, the doctor told us the baby was not going to come. He never bothered me. I didn't think it one day. First year, second year, third year, fourth year, I never thought of it one day. I was just busy doing my thing, playing. You know, women, and they get problems, pastor. Hey, you are not concerned. Yeah. Must I kill myself? Madam, relax. Madam, relax your mind. One day I was away and she called me and said, I'm looking for who to talk to. What is that? He said, the thing has happened. Hey, okay. Let's just continue our life. And it never crossed my mind one day. I was not bothered about it. I was not concerned about it. I never thought of it one day. The reason, there are some things I worried myself. There are some things. Nothing bothered me. Nothing worried me. Nothing disturbed me. I eat, finish, I sleep. Leave the rest for God. When it troubles me so much, I just look for one scripture. And when he gives me one word, I just hold the word and I leave the rest. It may tarry, but the word will come. What has he told you? Very many of us have forgotten what he has told us. And that's why we are running helter-skelter. His word can never be broken. His word will not fall to the ground empty. His word will accomplish that which was sent to do. All I look for, what is he saying in this matter? What is he saying? If he has spoken, leave the rest. I'll go and sleep. The first prayer point you are going to pray. Every power sponge fighting against your fruitfulness. Forces contending against your fruitfulness. Oh Lord, let those power expire. Are you ready? There are power that has vowed that you will not be fruitful. In the midst where God said you shall be fruitful. Forces that has vowed contending against your fruitfulness. They shall expire in the name of Jesus. Are you ready to pray that prayer? And the second prayer point, you are going to speak to yourself and speak to everything around you to receive God's word to be fruitful. Number one, let's quickly pray about it. Number one, let's go. Oh, say, my Father, my fighter.
My Father, my fighter.
Every power fighting against my fruitfulness.
Every power fighting against my fruitfulness.
What are you waiting for?
What are you waiting for?
Expire by fire.
Expire by fire.
Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Open your mouth and pray.
Expire. Contending with my fruitfulness. As I pray now. Expire. Expire.
In the name of Jesus. Hey. Let me quickly show you this scripture so that when we pray against, you know how to pray. Psalm 107 verse 34. Let's quickly bring it up. Psalm 107 verse 34. Are we there? Psalm 107. A fruitful land into barrenness. For the wickedness of them that dwell there. Okay. Want to go? Is it like that in your Bible? A fruitful land into what? How can a fruitful land into barrenness? No, how? A fruitful land into what? Now, a fruitful land into barrenness. For the wickedness of them that dwell therein. Meaning, they saw it that this land was fruitful and they decided to spoil it into barrenness. It's the wickedness of the people. They saw that this child would be fruitful and they said, no, let's spoil it to become barren. Are you ready to pray? They saw it. It started a fruitful land. Meaning the land you are dwelling is fruitful. He started by fruitfulness. There's something happened. What has entered your farm? No, we're talking on Friday in the all night. While men slept, the enemy came. It was not why they were awake. It was why they were sleeping the sleep of spiritual sleep, which is deadly. Physical sleep is good, but spiritual sleep is deadly. You are going to pray. Any forces turning my fruitful land into barrenness, making it a hard ground for me to tore. The land that God gave to me that was fruitful, then who has come to turn it into barrenness and is not making it difficult for me to tore? It's not making it difficult for me to labor. In the beginning, it was not so. But something happened. What has happened to it? When I married my husband, it was not like this.
Where were you before they now changed the man? You were sleeping. Where are you? Here, if you were not sleeping, where were you before they took the church from you? Where were you before they took that business? You were sleeping. Every power contending that wants to change your fruitful land into a barren land, as you open your mouth to pray, you shall reverse it in the name of Jesus. To pray. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Look at him again. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Every barren land shall be turned to fruitful land. In the name of Jesus. If you believe your prayer, are you ready?
Yeah.
A fruitful land. Into barrenness for the wickedness. It is the wickedness of men that make men pursue men and eat men. It is the wickedness of men. It's not because you committed an offense. See the way this choir is looking Christmas. But I know Christmas is still far. You just wear red. It's good. You know, now like Christmas carol that they wear red like this, but although you will wear red, it's good. So anybody that do any here, they will see any here, you will give them record. I have many records here. We'll give them record. Amen. You give them, I'll carry one of their, I'll give you record. So you need to, and when you are giving record, you will leave the field. So I will call some part. I will give anybody that do any, I will give the person record. And the record is not to leave the field, it's to leave the earth.
Amen.
Anyone that has found,
amen,
that you will labor in vain,
amen,
we will give them record.
Amen.
They said, over their dead body, you will be happy. Let them leave to go and wait for you. I don't have grace to pray for my enemy to live long. It's not a competition to see what I'll become in future. Don't see anything. Don't bother to see. It's not a competition to see. Minus one. We'll give them, are you ready to give them record? Everyone that has found that your land will not be fruitful. Everyone that has vowed that your children's land will not be fruitful. Everyone that has vowed that everything that once you put your hand will not be fruitful. In the name that is above every other name, this gate will open to swallow them.
Amen.
Everyone they've assigned to monitor you. They've assigned to follow you. By the power in the name of Jesus, in the resurrection Christ, I speak over your life and your destiny. You shall be fruitful in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everyone that has vowed and said you will not be fruitful, this earth will open to swallow them.
Amen.
I say it will swallow them.
Amen.
And you shall be fruitful.
Amen.
You shall be fruitful. Father, I speak over your people.
Yes, Lord.
You are going to pray lastly. I am fruitful. Everything that has to do with me is fruitful. Begin to prophesy it.
Yes, Lord.
Begin to speak it. I am fruitful. My wife is fruitful. My children are fruitful. Everything that has to do with us, we are fruitful. We shall multiply. Open your mouth, begin to decree, begin to declare.
begin to prophesy it. Zato baradabosa.
Zoto zoto zoto. Zeko zoto zote. Igro zodo godo. Zede gede. Zodo godo. Zede gede. Zodo godo. Zele kosi. Zoto zoto zoto. My family is fruitful. My job is fruitful. My business, my children.
Pastor to take over. Exodus. Exodus 1 verse 7. Quickly. You're going to put your name. Not to FM again. Okay. Where there is Israel, you will put, in case you forget your surname, you will put my own. Hello. In case you forget your own name, just put my own. My name is very simple, Peter. Are we ready? Yes. And in case when you get there, where is Israel? You remove Israel. You just put Peter there. In case you forget your name, I just said in case. I'm not in. You understand? I didn't force you. I'm not even telling you to put your pastor name. You just put my own. Amen. Are we ready? This is the scripture we are going to use to pray now. You will put your name. And the children of Peter. Are you with me? Can we read one to go? Put your name. Don't let your neighbor's voice be louder than your own. When he's reading his own, read your own. Hello. This land of America will hear you. The gate of this land will open for you. This earth will give you yield its harvest for you. The fruit in this land, you will harvest it in the name of Jesus. You will not give story. You have no excuse. Want to go? And the children of Peter were fruitful and increase abundantly and multiply. And was exceedingly mighty, and the land was filled with them. My children shall dominate this land. Hello. When they are talking of children that make way, that are influential, they shall call my children's name. Hello. They shall call my children's name. It
said, and the land was filled with them. They were filled of Peter's household. Have you not gone to a place, a community, a street? You just hear this street is just, is a family. Have you not seen it? You sure? It's one family. Okay, estate, you just see it. Is it a crime when your own, this one, your first son, hold one, the other one, you just hold the street like that. Just be going. Just be spreading. This is the scripture. He said, and the land was filled with them. With the children, it was filled with them. The earth is too big. Talk your own, I talk my own. There is space for everyone. Amen. There is space for everyone. I speak over your life. And the children that came from you, they shall be fruitful. Amen. You will not bite your finger over them. For you with this scripture, they shall increase in this land. They shall increase abundantly in this land. They shall not be wayward. They shall not be useless. They shall not be frustrated. In the name of Jesus, they shall multiply in this land. Everyone that is connected to you, they shall once exceedingly mighty. They will not be small. I said they will not be small. Stretch your hand. I said they will not be small. In the name of Jesus. They will hear of your children's name. They will make a standing record in their school. They will break protocols. In the name of Jesus. If you believe it, shout amen 7 times.